Since the very last week?
Probably the very last week of 2021, Mickey. And I really hope you guys all had an amazing Christmas. Yeah. Let us know in the comments if you received some cool knives for Christmas. Because you...
Or if you were forgotten by Santa Claus. But before we start this whole video, we gotta make some money too. And please visit our Patreon.
Oh, this is the last week that you can, the last week of the year that you can participate in this amazing giveaway. We are giving away 2 times the Falcon Even Embla. 1 times the TRC. This is free thanks to Tools for Gents.
Yeah,
we are giving away the Civivi Ortis. Nice small knife. And we are giving away the Lion Steel M5, the Siper M3V, thanks to Knives and Tools. Is it all? No, we're also giving away this knife. Yeah, nice. So yeah, we saw this video. Somebody tweeted us, I'm not on Twitter.
No.
Somebody just messaged me this video, said, hey, look guys, these guys used your shots of the Becker BK2.
Remember this one? K-Bar's Becker BK2 is a repeat performer on Survival Gear's Best Of lists.
In other words, this guy ripped your shots. And that doesn't matter because we don't mind. You know, I mean, but it doesn't matter that he didn't put our name there.
What did interest us though was the top 10 that he made. And he called it top 10 ultimate survival knives of 2022. And
so that's exactly what we are going to call our video.
And I don't want to, bash on this guy, but a lot of times these videos are made to make people click affiliate links.
Yeah.
So and this video is pretty well watched. So we thought, hey, let's give our look on our top 5 10 survival knives. And these have to be knives that we tried, because we cannot tell something about a knife that we haven't tried at all ourselves.
Yeah.
And we're gonna exclude the DBK knife, because you guys will think, oh, you guys are so biased.
Okay, so his number 10 is the K-Bar BK3 Tech Tool.
Can we take a look at that knife, please? Yeah. Becker, so let me...
This is so f***ing ugly.
Yeah, this is one of the ugliest knives, Becker. Okay.
Oh my god.
One thing, K-Bar Becker, the K-Bar knives are all really sturdy. So yeah, it would probably be a dependable knife. But Mickey, serrations, yeah.
Well, no, wait. Before you look so disgusted at the serrations,
yeah.
Can you remember us making a video about a serrated knife that we were not even that negative about the serrations?
No,
and if your knife is not sharp anymore in a survival situation,
yeah,
the serrations are good. But like the guy said in the video, a survival situation is a situation that you'd rather not be in. And
yeah,
how long?
Sure.
Is the average survival situation that you can be saved out
yeah,
of?
Yeah, it is. Probably 99% is saved within like the first 3 days.
And if you are not saved within the first 3 days, you are most probably gonna die.
Yeah.
So sucks. For the 0.0000001% that's gonna happen to.
Yeah.
Good job, the serrations.
Yeah,
and the other people, no. Our number 10
is the Dulo Viking.
Yeah.
That is a really beastie knife, Mickey. Look at it. Look.
Yeah.
This is like the knife that robs the K-Bar Becker BK2 of its title. Yeah.
What steel was this again?
This is Viking steel.
That is actually what the steel is called.
Yeah, it's called Viking. It's like or it's called a Austen mod. So it's a moderated version, a better version of the Austen.
So Lily Survival Lily should absolutely fall in love with this knife.
Yeah, she would love this knife. Oh. It is indestructible, but I do think it is too heavy that I think most people would just not put this in their backpack.
What you said before we were shooting this video, what you said was that it has to be a knife that you would probably have with you, and you are not going to take a knife which is probably about 20 pounds with you.
Exactly. A lot of people will probably say, but a big machete or something is going to be your best bet in the jungle or whatever, and that's true.
Yeah.
But if you're going backpacking or whatever, you're probably not having a machete stuck away in your backpack.
No.
So these are knives that are mostly easy to carry.
The Spyderco Waterway.
Yeah, so this...
I don't really get why this is... Why?
I'm not saying this is a bad knife. It's just really not a survival knife. It's thin. This is a hunting knife. This is good for hunting.
But I think we should change our tone a little. It looks like we're hating on the video. Well, we didn't hate the video.
Not hating,
because
yeah.
it is also an opinion. But yeah. in my opinion, that is a bad opinion.
Yeah.
Because our number nine actually is the Becker BK2, which you have. And not
yeah,
me.
And it's shared.
Where is
this,
it?
This spot is actually shared with your with the Treva Yakari Puco 140. Oh, yeah. He has this one in his list as well.
Yeah.
And that's
different place.
Yeah, different place. But it's yeah, this is for survival. You want a knife that it will probably never break on you.
Yeah.
And the Becker BK2 is a knife that I would highly depend my life on.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
And
because this is not going to break that knife.
This is not going to break.
We really put it through hell in that field,
yeah, yeah,
didn't
yeah.
we?
Yeah. But I would rather have this in an urban survival situation than in like a foresty situation.
Yeah, and that's where the Treva Yakari Puco 140 comes in, because it's kind of like a low-cue model. And
it has
it's a little
length.
Bit longer. You can... you can actually... do some bushcrafting with it, and it is not gonna break, because we pushed
we tried it, we literally
to the absolute limit.
We literally tried to break the Yakari Puco, and what I really love is that they have modified the spine to yeah. scrape a fire steel real well. So this yeah. is as indestructible, and it is more handleable.
And it is actually a knife that is not strange to take with you when you go on a hike or something.
Exactly.
And it is longer than normal.
Exactly.
Okay. Number eight. Because let's get it over with.
Yeah.
The Falkniven A1, the normal Falkniven A1, which is...
I was positively surprised.
With the price in America.
Yeah.
Oh my God, that's a lot cheaper than in Europe.
Yeah, but look, I'm surprised he put the Falkniven A1, because I think that's a good knife.
Yeah.
But to put this in your top 10, while there are exactly the same knives, but in better versions.
Yeah, yeah.
So this is absolutely not... like the best Falkniven A1 for a survival situation.
No. What is, Martin? What is?
We have here, Mickey, the Falkniven A1X and the Falkniven A1 Pro, both in COS.
So we actually brought out the wrong knife here, because this is not the A1's place yet.
But is this actually on the same spot as he put it? Or did I just pull them out?
No, it isn't.
No, we put the Tops BOB here.
Yeah, grab that thing off the table.
Okay, so we'll get back to these later, but we already said what we had to say.
Okay. I'll cut this out.
Tops BOB, the ultimate fire knife. But this one is in, this one is actually in 1095.
Yeah.
No, 1095. It is 195 cm steel.
154 cm steel. And what we really love about this knife is that in the video that we made about this, it was indestructible. We actually made a friction fire
with
this handle.
We made the friction fire, yeah.
It was actually really doable. So that is also a really big survival aspect. I mean,
yeah.
if it is survival, then probably a friction fire is something that you would try. And the steel was great.
Yeah,
the knife is a beast. And it is not that big. It is an actual knife that you would take with you, ladies
yeah, exactly.
and gentlemen.
And it's, of course, again, indestructible. Even has like this... place for scraping a fire steel, which
and destroying
I just
stuff,
prefer
and destroying
the,
stuff.
Yeah.
Hey, and one thing that is really important: their grinds, their sharpening on these knives are really good. Lately.
And the heat treatment as well.
Yeah. So put it away, because we're going to number seven. Number seven is the MSK1 survival knife. Hey, and you know what?
Yeah, you know what we put on that space? Something from a much bigger YouTuber. Survival Lily's knife, the April 1.
I don't really know what to say about this knife.
We haven't tested it.
No, I would say that it's a little expensive, $360. But who are we to say that? Because our knife is exactly that expensive.
Oh, but he has it now in as well in 154 cm steel. So that's a good upgrade.
Okay.
So, but of course, we don't know the knife.
What have we got on our number 7? It is. Oh.
Ooh, this is a very nice knife. And I'm jealous of.
We hebben een kleine foutje gemaakt, want eigenlijk was de Benchmade leuk.
Oh, Jesus!
We made another mistake. Because actually, this and the number 7 and number 8 should be in general. But the Benchmade leuk.
Yeah, so this is actually below the.
So this is number 7, the Tops BOB.
Yeah.
The Benchmade Loku is number 8. But nevertheless, the Benchmade Loku, CPM 3V knife, a good fire steel scraper, good
concealed
steel,
handle.
Concealed blade.
Handle.
Concealed handle. Nice length.
Yeah.
Can do everything well, come sharp out of the factory.
It's light, doesn't tire you.
Yeah, and it's tough. I don't think we should say anything more about it because we made the mistake in the video. We got to keep it snappy, we got to keep
it
going.
Great knife. And also for the price, of course.
Number six. The Gerber Strong Arm. And do we know that knife?
Yeah. Yeah. I mean, look. It is a very, very sturdy tent peg. That's what it is.
Yeah.
It's a very sturdy tent peg. It's not a knife. It is just it's dull. It has an unsharpened part where the blade starts, so it's very annoying for carving and stuff.
Yeah.
Look, the one thing that is probably good at is anchoring yourself to a side of a rock. That's where it's good at.
Yeah.
It's a very sturdy tent peg, like I said.
That's what
it is.
Or to hang up a painting or something.
Yeah.
No, but all jokes aside, this knife really hurt our hand with batoning, and it was from all the knives, it was one of the worst knives that we tested this year. Martin is suddenly just is gone.
So yeah, we put this knife through hell. We could not break it, but it's just not a good knife. So I would not. I don't want to have this with me.
Oh, then our number six.
Yeah, that is a really nice knife, Mickey.
Is Melanica Leuke. Yeah. Look at it.
This is also like the Dulo. This is a custom knife.
Martin, I cannot remember. There's rust on my knife.
Of course, there's rust on your knife.
I can't remember what
Crewware.
Was this Crewware?
Crewware, yeah.
Oh my god, that is
so
crazy.
This steel is unbreakable. This knife is unbreakable. Again, concealed tang, which might scare a little bit because you don't know how big the tang is. But I saw pictures from Melanica and it's probably unbreakable. I would depend my life on it.
Tell me, boys. Because
tell me about it.
Why I would say that it is higher than the Tops BOB or the Becker BK2 or the Viking knife is because look, it can chop way better and stuff.
It was an amazing chopper actually.
Yeah. Well, and all that stuff, but actually for destruction and shit, you cannot use the backside.
No.
And I think if I would have to depend my life on something, the Tops BOB is probably going to be more sturdy overall.
But it depends also a little bit, I think, where you would be stranded. Look, if I'm in an urban situation, I would need to crack open stuff.
Yeah.
This would be nicer, but for like in a forest, a jungle, for fire making and stuff, I would appreciate this knife more.
Yeah, even though it isn't stainless, but it is semi-stainless.
Yeah, but for that 3 days, 4 days, should be fine.
Because now we go to number five and...
Yes, the hell, Utbert. If I
I don't really get why that is on number five.
No, it's a bushcraft knife. It's not definitely not a bad knife that they put here, but...
it's just, for me, it looks like just a bushcraft knife.
Yeah, it's not really a survival knife.
12C27 stainless steel. So yeah, I don't really get why this would be, for instance, higher than the A1.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah, we realize that. So I don't really
that's
get
crazy.
Why it
I don't know what kind of thoughts he put in making like the top 10 list.
Our number five is a really special knife.
Yeah.
It is the Valkneven Modern Bowie.
Yeah, that is a very crazy knife. Probably, Mickey, if I would have to end up with one of these knives, I would be very happy if that knife was the one that I would be stuck with but the fact is, why is it on number five? Because it's still like the size that not a lot of people are going to
carry it with them. Yeah,
with them. This is something that you would throw in the back of your car, so if you are surrounded with your car, of course this would be a very, very great survival knife to have.
Yeah,
but then again, for look, if I'm going to hike a mountain, I'm probably not gonna weigh myself down with this knife.
No. So the chances that you're gonna take that you're gonna have this with you in a hiking trip or some trip that you're gonna find
very
yourself
slim
in a survival situation, not that big. So let's go to the number four. His number four was the Tops Knives Brachimo. And that looks like a
So again, look, it's a fire. It's a knife that is based around making fire and stuff.
Yeah.
But then again, why not choose the Tops BOB? Because this is clearly just a better version of that for survival.
Look. This knife has got a 1095 steel.
Yeah.
Yeah. For a survival knife, I would love to have a good stainless steel.
Yeah,
so
yeah.
While you're at it, why not get yourself the 154 cm steel?
Yeah, and even if you have a different opinion, you can also get this knife at 1095, and that would still be a better choice for survival than that.
Yeah, in my opinion, it would. It looks a little bit sturdier and stuff, a little bit heavier. So if you would want to chop with a knife, it could do.
Yeah.
What was our number four actually? Our number four was, ooh, a knife that we do not have with us.
I sent it back because I chipped it a little bit and I wanted to have
give it a spa treatment.
A spa treatment from Bark River.
Yeah.
Because it's the Bravo 1. It could also be the Bravo 1.25 or the Bravo 1.5.
Yeah.
But it has to be in CPM3V, of course, or Crewwear.
Bravo 1 is actually, in my opinion, one of the sickest knives ever made because it feels way better than the Becker BK2. In terms of handling and stuff.
We actually made a video with the Becker BK2 VS, the Bark River Bravo 1. Oh yeah, in the past, because these are pretty similar, but this is just like the beastie version of the Bravo 1. Yeah, but then again, the Bravo 1 has like the best handle ergonomics like of any knife that I know, in my opinion. And of course, the steel, the sturdiness, it is just a very well-designed knife. I think it was even designed by a kind of American military section, like special forces section. And please get it without the thumb thing, because that hurts.
Look, the Mora Knife Companion Spark, the Mora Spark.
So that's his number three.
Yeah, that is his number three. Well, and I actually opted to Martin to put it in our top 10 list as well. But Martin said correctly, like, if it's not that big of a hassle to bring your own fire steel.
Yeah.
And I thought, you know what? That is true. Why would you give in, or why would you make a consensus?
It's a good knife. This is something that I would probably throw in my girlfriend's photography bag or whatever, you know? That if she gets lost or whatever, then she has a knife that she doesn't mind carrying around because it's not aggressive. It's not heavy.
Okay, well, anyway, I would say put this on number 8 or something on your top 10 list from the other video. Our number 3 is the TRC Apocalypse. Have I got that one here?
Yeah, you have one as well. And I have one too.
Nice. I have the normal edition. Marta's got the DBK edition.
Prototype DBK edition, actually.
Yeah, and you know what? The biggest difference with the DBK edition is that it has a convex.
Yeah. So this knife, although it has a rounded spine, it does scrape a fire steel pretty well.
Yeah.
And in my opinion, it is almost the same size as like the A1.
Yeah.
But it has such nifty features and it has such an amazing heat treatment. For me, this is one of the best knives in this size that you can possibly buy.
Yeah, and the funny thing is that normally then you would, of course, you would wear gloves. In this weather already, and I think it's about 60 degrees Celsius or something, you can already feel how cold the steel is in your hands.
Yeah.
And that is 6 degrees Celsius. So, number 2, we're actually nearing the end of this video because
exciting. Are you guys as excited as I am?
Martin, it is the SC Laser Strike knife.
Yeah.
You know what? I really don't mind him putting an SC in there. Because, an SC is a good...
Yeah, but I have some SCs here as well. And there are a few problems that I have with them. And I know that SC is releasing like the 3D handles and stuff, and that's already way better. But looking at that handle, and of course I don't have experience with that knife, these are pretty heavy for what they are.
Yeah.
And the handle's just not very ergonomic. It's just a square. And...
it doesn't keep an edge.
It doesn't keep an edge. So... if you are surviving 3 days, you are not going to want to end up in a situation where you have to like sharpen a knife on river rocks. Yeah? You just want to have a sharp knife for 3 days.
Our number 2 is a knife that we actually already showed. It's the Falcon Even! A1X or the Falcon Evo A1 Pro. Why would you take the Falcon Evo A1X? And why would you take the A1 Pro? Well, you would take the Falcon Evo A1X when? You go on a survival trip that isn't very cold. And if you go in a snowy, very freezing trip...
You want a concealed handle.
Yep. Because that is very nice with gloves, blah, blah, blah.
Yeah. Indestructible knives, just really good design. I mean, a lot of military people use this knife, issue this knife.
He put the normal A1 in there.
Yeah.
We say, hey.
Up that a little bit.
Up that a little bit. I mean, hey, if you're making a list, it is the best knives. Yeah. We didn't put the best value survival knives. No, the best survival knives. And that's why this one, the more expensive ones are in
well
this list.
Well said, Mickey.
Well, my English is pretty well today.
Nice,
you know that?
Nice.
Then I made a mistake there. Pretty good today. and his number one, surprisingly, is the Becker BK2.
So honored that he used our footage for it, of course. But then again, it is indestructible. So this maybe is among the highest rating in indestructibility.
Yeah.
But then again,
and for indestructibility.
Indestructible. But then again, for survival, it is. Bit of a heavy knife, of course. It doesn't have this handle when you buy it, so the handle is less nice. It is just a little bit bulky, and for bushcraft or outdoor tasks, not my favorite pick.
No.
But it is, of course, also in our top 10. It is indestructible, and I would be happy if this would
be on my belt.
Yeah.
Well, an hour. Top one pick might surprise people, and
maybe it also surprised us when we tested it.
Yeah. It is probably
like big time.
By far the most ugly knife in my whole collection. it is most definitely the most ugly knife in my collection.
But it has a very specific style.
It is so unbelievably good.
Yeah.
The Extrema Ratio Salvage.
Yeah. So Mickey, why is this knife so good? Why did it surprise us this much?
Man. This looks like a goddamn science project, and actually
it is a science project.
This is designed to do everything, this handle, and to be the best handle, and it can do everything. You can choke up on it here and make very nice feather sticks, and it handles really well, and you can use it as a great chopping knife.
It chops absolute great.
Beast.
It batoned amazing. It felt indestructible.
Yeah.
Good scrape price, you.
Martin, feel this.
Oh, yeah, it can scrape.
And even look, it's even got little logos on it. You know,
it's made for scraping fire steel.
And this is an amazing knife. Look, this tento design, I don't really like tento designs, but it made sure you could carve really well.
Yeah, it did. This knife, if you look at it, it has like a lot of features that we personally don't like, but all those kind of features did surprise us really big.
Yeah.
And of course, again, Mickey, concealed handle, so this is also good in cold weather.
Can I please have this? Look, if you have a Falcon Even like this, you would chop it like this, and maybe if you've got your lanyard on here. But this knife is a lot smaller, but this is the place where you chop with, and this is the place where you chop here. It's almost at the same spot.
Yeah.
And because of the leverage of this knife, I wouldn't be surprised that it would chop a little harder than the modern Bowie.
Yeah, and
all
Mickey,
that
this is
in a very good size. It is an amazingly designed knife.
It is just N690s too, so nothing exciting or something.
No, but it,
but
really
it did really well. It did really well.
Yeah,
so this is
number one. I have to say that for a survival knife, if I would go on a survival trip, well, that would actually be a very bad idea to go on a survival trip, seeing that is not fun. But this knife is an absolute beast.
Yeah.
An absolute beast, isn't it?
Yeah, it blew us away on every front.
So, Extrema Ratio, well done by designing this knife. I also love that it is this ugly, but that good, you know? It is actually that ugly kid in the class that, you know, gets all the women and, you know, wins
just
in every sport.
Just because he's a performer,
And wins in every sport, is a bloody beast. It doesn't matter. It is an absolute beast. I really love having this knife.
Yeah.
So, happy 2022, ladies and gentlemen. Yeah. And we already had Christmas.
Yeah.
Hope you had a good Christmas.
And let's start off this new year with DBK knives in your hands.
Hey. We got a bunch.
Yeah.
Like, subscribe. Every Thursday, 1 p.m. PDT, we will never miss a week.
And Dutch Museum Nights will never die!